G'day. Today I'm going to be G'day. Today I'm going to be reading Stuart Hall's Encode and Decode. Traditionally, mass communications research has conceptualized the process of communications in terms of circulation circuit or loop. This model has been criticized for its linearity, sender, message, receiver, for its concentration on the level of message exchange, and for the absence of a structured conception of different moments as a complex structure of relations. But it is also possible and useful to think of this process in terms of the structure produced and sustained through the articulation of the distinctive moments, production, circulation, distribution, consumption, reproduction. This would be to think of the process as a complex structure in dominance, sustained through the articulation of connected practices, each of which, however, retains its distinctiveness and has its own specific modality, its own forms and conditions of existence. The object of these practices is meanings and messages in the form of assigned vehicles of a specific kind organized, like any form of communication or language, through the operation of codes within the syntagmatic chain, within the syntagmatic chain of the discourse, the apparatuses, relations, and practices of production thus issue at a certain moment, the moment of production of circulation in the form of symbolic vehicles constituted within the rules of the region. It is in this discursive form that the circulation of the product takes place. The process thus requires at the production end its material instruments, its means, as well as its own sets of social production relations. The organization and combination of practices within media apparatuses, but it is in the discursive form that the circulation of the product takes place, as well as its distribution to different audiences. Once accomplished, the discourse must then be translated and transformed again into social practices if the circuit is both completed and effective. If no meaning is taken, there can be no consumption. If the meaning is not articulated in practice, it has no effect. The value of this approach is that while each of the moments in articulation is necessary to the circuit as a whole, no one moment can fully guarantee the next moment with which it is articulated, since each has its specific modality and conditions of existence. Each can come to constitute its own break or interruption of the passage of forms, on whose continuity the flow of effective production, that is, reproduction, depends. Thus, while in no way wanting to limit research to the following only those leads which emerge from content analysis, we must recognize that discursive form and of the message has a privileged position in the communicative exchange from the viewpoint of circulation, and that the moments of encoding and decoding, though only relatively autonomous in relation to the communicative process as a whole, are determinate moments. A raw historical event cannot, in that form, be transmitted by, say, a television newscast. Events can only be signified within the oral visual forms of the televisual discourse. In the moment when a historical event passes under the sign of discourse, it is subject to all of the complex formal rules by which language signifies. To put it paradoxically, the event must become a story before it can become a communicative event. In that moment, the formal sub-rules of discourse are in dominance, without, of course, subordinating out of existence the historical event so signified, the social relations in which the rules are set to work, or the social and political consequences of the event having been signified in this way. The message form is the necessary form of appearance of the event in its passage from the source to receiver, thus the transposition into and out of the message form, or the mode of symbolic exchange, is not random moment which can take up or ignore at our convenience. The message form is a determinate moment, though at another level it comprises the surface movements of the communication system only and requires at another stage to be integrated into the social relations of the communications process as a whole, of which it forms only a part. And I'll stop there. Thanks for listening.